No, build a new one. Now, we have now 19 people. Michael.
Yeah.
Michael, say that again. I didn't hear you.
Okay, I try again, Yamshid. We have only connection problems at the moment with my people who are trying to upload. No, all of us.
So
especially the lady, especially the student who is trying to upload our film into. A Google Drive that is being run by you, which we can load to. No.
So, listen, guys. By the way, from now on, you're actually online. So,
hello, Europe.
The whole entire Europe is looking at you. So don't swear. Don't use too many fuck words. Only Mr. Kassaei who can do that. Yeah. So listen, a couple of things for every one of you, and allow me to mute you all so I'm not having any, so that's better. Couple of things. I understood from Michael that he and his team are having internet problems, and that means they are still trying to upload something. I understood all of that. I don't know how exactly to help. The only thing I heard about that, Michael, was that you said people are uploading something on my Google Drive page. I have no Google Drive page. That's not what I meant. So I hope that, I know you cannot talk because I muted you. So if your videos are so heavy that you fear during your presentations, it is not running on this platform, we suggested upload them on a Google Drive, share the link. My suggestion to you, however, is those of you who want to risk it and run it on this platform should please do it, because everyone who is watching you from outside on YouTube cannot see that if you outsource it on the Google Drive. So that said, I give you Michael talk, if you like.
So I'm listening. I'm listening to you. Yeah.
Yeah. So tell me, how can I help you before
we Well, you know, it's just the experience is going to be useless if this platform can't handle it. And this platform does not seem to be able to handle it even in our room. And it's not a heavy movie. It's only 200 megabytes, which is nothing. But the platform is not able to deal with it properly, especially the sound, especially the sound.
Yeah, I don't know how to help.
Well, I'm just saying that's why outsourcing it to a Google Drive, we don't particularly care that much about the people watching from the outside.
Sure.
We are concerned about the people inside.
Absolutely. So therefore,
sorry for that.
Therefore, and as I had suggested to you and to everyone else, any one of you who wants to play it on a better quality for everyone individually, please upload, share the link when the time comes. And then for that moment, every one of us go on a browser, watch the video, and then we get back together here again.
Okay. If I can suggest something about the video, usually the person that is sharing their screen, there is something at the bottom of the screen that says optimize video on full screen. So if you click on that, it actually helps, because we had the same issue earlier and that's how we fixed it. Because now we rehearse and it runs smoothly. I don't know if it's going to work for everybody, but that's what Zoom suggests as well.
Optimize screen share for video clip. Is that what you mean? Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you very much, Mira. Thank you. Okay. Okay. I'll go back and see you soon.
No, you go nowhere. Where are you going?
Everyone, I want to go back to my room.
No, there is no room anymore. Rooms are closed. Everyone are here.
Oh, my people are here?
Yes,
okay.
Everyone.
I'll find
out. The entire world is here. So, happy people. Thank you very much. I actually would like to pass on directly to HP. This is his playground, so let him launch this entire presentations. HP.
Hello, Europe. After this small bits and pieces about technique, hello, Europe. I'm so super happy and glad to have you all here, to have you after these 3 days of heavy work and of interesting things going on. It worked out super fine, everything, until now. Now we're looking forward to have two presentations. The Creative Express, the basic idea is that we are never ever in an office working or something like that. We also always tend to be sort of in the briefing or in the problem, like we had been in the first Creative Express. We have been in the train from Innsbruck to Vienna. We have been on the ship. We have been in the gondola in the Alps to have a briefing which was around this location we were. And now we are right in the middle of the problem we are dealing with. We are in this crisis. We are in this corona, no, these words are not my words. So we are a part of the problem, and maybe we can deal with the problem and have some solutions. 1,000 thanks to all the participants, 1,000 thanks to all the coaches, 1,000 thanks to the team in Barcelona, 1,100 thanks to Jamshid, who did all this technical stuff. What we experienced in these 3 days is something for me completely new. We had been together. We had been together online, but we had been together. There had been some feelings between people and groups, and it was really astonishing what happened. And we again had experienced this idea of Europe, to work together, to be united, to help each other, to feel this spirit of Europe. And this spirit of, one guy has been with us, was not really with us, but his spirit had been with us. It is Johannes Nevelke, one of the fathers of the Great Express, and his spirit took us and inspired us. Johannes passed away 2 weeks ago, killed by Corona, but his spirit and his inspiration have been with us. So thanks, Johannes, for all the ideas you sent back to the teams. We are now starting to have the first presentations. I'm sure I forgot to thank whatever and to say lots of things. This is afterwards, but now we are super, super curious for the first presentations. Jamshid, do you have any technical hits and hints, or let's start with group number one, team number one? Yes?
Absolutely. You guys just mute yourself if you're not talking. As usual, you all did a great job during these 3 days. So hit the road. I'm happy to be called technical guy. I have no idea what technology
at all. Come on, you're a strategic super brain with technical assets. who is the coach of team number one?
That's me.
Hannes.
Yeah. Yeah, the group has been fantastic working together from Ukraine and Spain and Ireland and Czech Republic. They have a very simple but downright genius idea that they're going to present to all of us now. And I'll just mute myself and let the team talk. So go team one.
Hi everyone. I'm going to be presenting for team one. I don't know if everyone can see me, can you?
No, you need to share your screen first with us. You'll find that at the bottom in the middle with the green button.
Who's taking the time?
I am.
Okay.
Not yet, time is not running yet.
The time has started when she start talking, okay?
No
okay.
Way.
Don't start, it's not fair.
But come on.
Okay, so.
We don't see you yet. You need to share your screen. Yes, now it's working.
It's working.
There you go, yeah, great.
Okay, good.
And then you have to go to full screen and then you...
So just to say that we have a video that we will be playing. I have put the link into the box. And if anyone else wants to look for it, it's called Eurovision Song of Hope. Sorry about this. Okay. Can everyone see the presentation? Yeah. Okay, perfect. Okay. So we are team. I'd like to introduce who's in the team. So it's myself presenting Ruby Corcoran from Ireland. I'm a designer. We have Elisa, our art director from Ukraine. Hannes, our great coach for the last 3 days. Roman, our copywriter, and Marcos from Spain, our art director. And I'd like to start this presentation, I guess. So our brief was to help unite Europe in some sort of way. So we found solutions and we found that it's such a complex task. It's a lot harder than we imagined. So we thought we'd present something that was simple, that everyone can be involved in, and it's well known. So if you can't say it, sing it. And how do we get this across to the whole of Europe? We tandem with the most well-known channel there is, Eurovision Song Contest. If you're familiar with Eurovision, each country takes part every single year, and it's a battle of the countries. So what we wanted to do this year was to unite every country together and have them working together rather than apart, uniting every country together. So the year being cancelled for the first time ever, but for the first time ever by bringing all these countries together. So this year, the Eurovision was supposed to be held in Rotterdam 2020. But unfortunately, this isn't going ahead next month. So our idea was to unite the countries through the Song of Hope. We want to use music as a way to unite countries together. So the link that I sent to everyone, we've created a video to help share our idea. It's on YouTube and it's through the link if everyone can open it up. I'll play it here as well so you can see. So hopefully everyone had the chance to watch this short clip. We really just want to get the idea across that we want to use the representatives of every country this year that we're going to be playing next month to actually play together where they are, to bring all these artists together and to generate a movement that will get people in their own houses to work together and to sing together. We want to spread hope throughout the nations. As well as this, we would like to create a way to bring people at home together and sing together. We would like to have an interactive platform online on the Eurovision website where people from different countries can come together, join together and sing together. This can be shared throughout social media to get this message across throughout radio, TV, the likes of social media platforms. And in the last couple of months, we've seen a huge amount of engagement between people coming together online. And we want to spread this through music by having countries coming together and singing together. We would also like to have merchandise to raise money for people throughout Europe through this hard time. Based on the logo, which was with all the countries coming together, we would like people to have the chance to create their own merchandise generated by themselves based on the logo. This logo was designed by Clever Frank, and each country is integrated into the logo. We want a point for people to be able to design their own merchandise they can wear while taking part in this new open air concert for everyone to be part of. This is just an example of how this logo can be varied and people can generate their flags together. So the message we really want to spread is everything is going to be all right. It will be all right if we come together, no matter where we are, but if we stay strong, every little thing is going to be all right. That's the end. Thank you. Thanks for taking the time.
Thank you very much. Please unshare your videos.
Very, very, very good. Very, very good. Fantastic. Goosebumps. Goosebumps.
Great. So, merci and HP. This is the task
Ruby,
for the next few.
Unshare your screen, please.
Okay.
But we have to talk to Eurovision instantly.
Yes.
Absolutely. Yes. Charlotte, please be prepared. Your team will be next because there's the technical whatever at Michael. I heard his dog, by the way. A fantastic super idea. The super look, the CI and the opticals is just breathtaking, fantastic, super. Well, now that's the level. Okay, Hannes, you are right. Fuck. So, team number three, are you ready?
Yes,
of Yuramba. Course, team number three is ready.
Of course. Okay.
I had the honor and great fun to work with team number three, who is Anouk, Rita, Mira, and Mirjera, like four young, super burning, creative rocket women. And I'm super excited to, now see you presenting the idea, and also very happy to see such a great female future in our industry. This is something really special. And now I'm gonna mute because you've got much more to say.
Thank you. I hope you all see my screen now.
Beautiful.
Beautiful, good. I just wait a sec. I have to fix something. And yes. So I have the honor to present for Team Hungary, or also known as Team 3, as Charlotte already introduced us. In this team is Rita, Mira, Mireia, and myself. I'm Anouk, and of course our super cool coach Charlotte. So let's start. How can we make Europeans feel unified? This is not an easy task, especially not in a time in which our borders are closed, we can't travel, we're stuck at home, and a lot of people feel lonely. But it's also a really great opportunity, even though we're socially distanced, there is a lot that connects us. as we probably all experienced this weekend. Even though we're from different countries and in different contexts, we share the same worries. And we also look forward to the same things. And especially being for quite a long time in this situation, we think that we are all hungry. We are hungry for meeting new people. I mean, this weekend is probably the best proof for it. We are hungry for visiting new places, even though we all love our homes, but after a while, it would be also nice to see some other places as well. We're hungry for seeing new things and getting inspired. And we're hungry for tasting new flavors. We are hungry for Europe. But this is something you cannot just communicate. It's something you really have to experience, because in the end, it's experience what connects.
Yes, está buena, eh?
Yeah.
Ah, no está buena.
Somos 53, güey.
Guys, sí. If you talk,
mira,
Clara,
can you please all mute? Sorry, go ahead.
Okay, go ahead. So we really need to experience this. And what brings us more together than sharing a dinner? Because this is really the time where you take the time to listen carefully to others, to also celebrate being together and to share feelings. So therefore, we launch Hungry for Europe, Share a Bite with Someone. So we would launch a platform which actually matches you with a random people in Europe for a dinner date. So you would have a surprise guest for dinner with whom you can share a bite of culture, a bite of your life, a bite of your country. And how this would work, let's have a look. So ready for dinner and to meet our surprise guest. So wow, connecting to Denmark. Hi, really exciting. Nice to meet you. And actually don't even know to know English. There is the Google Voice Translator, and you can also share a picture. And after dinner, if you're still hungry, there are a lot of recipes from all over Europe, because every participant can post the favorite recipe. And you also have the chance to donate a dinner, because the platform would also help people who are in need. So, and cooperate with an organization, for example, Share the Meal, and then you can donate only 1 euro and it goes to a person who can't afford a dinner. How we would, and here you see some examples how this would look like. It looked a lot like this the last couple of days also on your on our tables. And yes, how we would announce it. We would actually do a Facebook event and try to spread the word, and we would announce the biggest dinner party all over Europe. So for that, we would also promote this with posters. And as you can see, it's really playful. It really draws your attention because of this color, colors we use. These colors are based on actually the colors of the flags from Europe. So from the country from Europe. And we would also try to cooperate with food deliveries to give away flyers, which would also promote this launch of Hungry for Europe. And the aim is, of course, to get some media coverage. Yes, for the biggest dinner party, which takes place all over Europe. And after when it will be launched, we would promote it further. For example, with this
video. Yeah!
I'm hungry, hungry, hungry. I want eggs. Hungry, hungry, hungry. I want crab legs. Hungry, hungry, hungry. I want stew. Hungry, hungry, hungry. Hungry, hungry, hungry. Hungry, hungry, hungry. I want you.
So I hope that the video worked. Otherwise, there would also be a link which we posted, and you can see the video as well. And we would also have social media ads, like with this real situations of having dinner through Europe together, or like this. And to bring it further, we thought of something which would even go a step further. So if Europeans are together at the table, the politicians should also take a seat. And when the community is established, we would collect signatures from them to bring the politicians on the table to discuss the future of Europe. And we were also thinking of potential cooperation partners. And here we really also see the opportunity to not only cooperate with one company, but also with different ones and bring this together to life. So we were thinking of the food industry. It could be supermarkets involved, but also delivery services like Uber Eats or Food Panda, and also communication companies, especially digital ones. So for example, also Zoom, who could help to provide the platform, for example. So let's be hungry for Europe.
Oh, fantastic, fantastic. I'd love to have dinner with you, with all of you. Hannes, what do you say now? I mean, your level that was high, but I mean, you can sing while dinner a song for Europe as well. Or?
You want a real answer? I think the problem is to get the thing media-wise across. That was the main point where we were thinking hooking us together with Eurovision Song Contest, because we need media power. I think will be the thing. But I love the idea, nevertheless. By instant, it looks already like really being feasible to put into the ADCE Europe website.
We'll do that.
I love it. Great
idea. We'll do that. So we jump to team number four. Marjorieth, your team is now the one. Are you playing video games on your iPhone?
No, I'm inviting people to watch this stuff.
Cool. Very good. You are our promotion girl, Marjorieth.
So hello, Europe. Your hello, team. Europe. You know, thank you very much. Yes, we are the team number four. And I had the pleasure to have like really nice people in my team. We had Tanya, we have Vil, Luca, and we have Mary from Cyprus, Lucas from Finland, Vil from Portugal, and Tanya from Spain, living in Munich. I want to say thank you very much. The guys worked very much, and they were exactly, Hannes, the point that you were saying, you know? It was like, is it doable, you know? Is it like, is it something that you can try to make happen or no? And at the end, the guys had a very good idea to create a revolution and to try to create a movement. And I'm very, I was very proud to say, like, wow, that is very interesting. And actually, if they did this, it will be like such a great idea. And I think that Lucas will present that for you guys. And I'm very happy, you know, because it was, we, as you say, Hannes, we were struggling a lot in like, is this something that we could really, for example, talk to the European Union and tell them about it? Is this something that we can get people to be part of the thing, you know? So it took them a lot of time to try to brainstorm what will be the news or like something that is never seen before. But at the same time, easy to understand, to try to get people to be part of this movement. So I will give my chance now to Luca, which will present with Tanya our presentation. And yeah, go for it, guys.
Okay, can you hear me?
Absolutely.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, and you can see the screen.
And can you hear me also?
Yes,
we can. Perfect.
Okay, and Will?
Will?
Will here?
Yes,
okay.
Sorry.
Okay, nice. Okay, so we are team four. And as you all notice, we are sitting in front of screens, and that's an indication of us living in very peculiar times. We live in uncertain times. There's every day borders closing all around us. Death figures are on the rise, and it's all very troubling. All we hear from other countries around us are bad news, false news, and misinformed news. Will warm weather really kill off COVID-19? Nobody really knows. So people need to read good news. And the good thing is that good news have a lot of good benefits for us. For example, health-wise, by having a good mood, you're more likely to have a good immune system. And a stressful situation in your life is really not a good thing for creativity. So we're really in a need for good news.
And the good news are that the people love good news.
And in fact, there is a lot of good news around us. The problem is that we just have to dig for them. So we need a solution.
And we want to change that. We present in the good news.
So the good news is a European movement that takes over newspapers with only the good news. So we want to gather all the good news in one place. It's a radical move for all European newspapers to take societal responsibility and spread positive news that will bring Europeans closer together. It celebrates happy moments in rough times and the people from diverse cultures and places in Europe. It celebrates the ones who shine a light for the others to see.
And we are not going to stop until complete Europe together have a sign in common, and that is good news for one day.
So the good news takes over a new European newspaper for one day a week. So the complete newspaper is only based on good news. So we're blasting the European citizens with only optimism.
And what day is the best one for this good news? I think we want to turn bad Mondays to good Mondays.
So the movement is based on Mondays with only good news. So how does it work? Well, We have newspapers who are already creating articles, and our responsibility is to gather them into one place. So we have existing newspapers, and each week we are collecting them and then distributing them back. So you get some news from Spain and from Finland and from Cyprus, and they are gathered, and suddenly they are in a German newspaper. Everybody gets it.
And good news will be pegged with quality content and, of course, optimistic news.
So we have positive news from, for example, England, with, for example, everybody is getting tired about bad news, unfortunately, relating to hospitals. So, of course, we have a therapy dog called Dr. Loki, delivering hero healing kits to healthcare workers. This is something that everybody needs to know.
Or the grandma signs happy birthday to me and then says the turn 92.
And of course, we have a hashtag that is Good News EU, so that everybody can also share their own good news with everyone else.
Follow the movement.
And of course, these good news need to create and need to get a lot of attention. And that means that, for example, we have The Guardian, and when it's released on Mondays, it will have a complete rehaul design-wise that will be attractive, eye-catching, and overall a bit more optimistic than we are used to. And it's not only the cover, we also have all the inside, all the content of the website, of the newspaper, will be made with the best European journalists, writers, illustrators, and photographers. And it's a bit in human nature to focus on the bad things in life. So we tend to forget that we are on a timeline and that things are actually going in a better direction in most countries. So the good news also has the societal responsibility of reminding the people that we are in fact going in the right direction. So we want really nice infographics to show this as well. And of course, we already have a lot of collaborators in the form of other newspapers in other countries, but we could also have cultural organizers that could contribute to the good news by giving discounts and offers to big cultural events, for example, music events. So we can have people who read the good news get to go to the best music gigs.
The good news is that tomorrow is Monday, and we have a lot of good news to share about this experience. We hope everyone feels the same. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. It could be like for the press and all the media, also a push in their ass to move forward, to be optimistic and to tell people and believe in their own media. Fantastic. Thank you very much.
Could you imagine you. The Bild Zeitung for complete Monday only with good news?
I think the cover is fine because people love to have all bad news as well, but it's a fantastic idea. Great. Thank Go you. For it.
Thank you.
Team number five. Thank you, Marjo. Thank you, team number four. Now team number five. Julia.
Hi.
And her fantastic team.
Yeah, sorry for the noise. We just got pizza, you know, that's the beauty of home office, I guess. So if there is something ringing, never mind. Guys.
Pizza for everybody.
My husband is getting pizza now.
Pizza for everybody. This is, no, that's the answer.
Only happens to me.
The dinner idea for everybody at now, at the next minutes. Okay. You, please tell us about your group and what they are thinking about, whatever you're doing.
Yeah, so it was, you know, a pleasure to work with them because, they are all great and I was very impressed. you know, how they bond immediately with each other, which, you know, being a creative sometimes doesn't happen, but it went so smoothly and, you know, everybody had a great team spirit. So I'm very proud of them. And I think, you know, they brought a very bold idea that, you know, it's very inclusive because, you know, we are talking about Europe, right? And I think they found a way how to, you know, save people from boredom and depression in a very cool and uplifting way. So I'm very excited for the presentation. Robert and Stephanie, please.
Yeah, no pressure. Can everyone hear me?
Who cares? Okay. Yeah, yes, of course we hear you. Yes.
And can everyone see the screen?
Yes.
Perfect. Okay. As you know, for the last couple of weeks, life has been put on pause. It's time we're basically wasting, but we shouldn't. We should make the most of it. And exactly during the last couple of weeks, gaming has risen from 7.2 million users at the same time to 23.5 million. What are we going to do about this? We present the New European Union, or how we're going to turn isolation into therapeutical interaction that will give hope back to millions. You all know the classic EU flag. We decided to give our own twist on it that shows how united we can be in this trying time. What's the general idea? In collaboration with Minecraft, we will create our own Europe without borders that will be this whole European Union. And now let's talk about the campaign and how it actually works. First, we start by creating awareness. We will project our own posters that will pick up exactly from the moment that people feel isolated and missing their normal lives. Remember the Paris trip you never took? You can still surprise her. Got church on Sunday, build it on Saturday. When's the last time you got coffee with your bestie? Here's your next chance. So we're also gonna create engagement by creating a live show. As you may know, Minecraft is a game about building and creating. So since we're gonna have Europe in this game, we decided to mirror the Europe in the game in real world using live digital mapping. To participate in this campaign, people will have to go to our landing page and take a pledge of isolation. By taking this pledge of isolation, everyone will receive the game for free to become a citizen and play inside. And it's rated D for everyone. What does that mean? We aim to be inclusive, and that means we have to take care of older generations. So we'll have younger volunteers come in and introduce the older generations to our platform so they can discover it and build with us. Play, build, and connect. Like I said, this is a game about building, but for us in this context, it can be so much more. It can be about rebuilding Europe or about reimagining it. It can be about connecting or reconnecting, discovering someone new, or hanging out with your family. And it gives us a lot of opportunities because we can have events like we would in real life. We can have something as small as a birthday or as big as a concert or as huge as actual elections. And there's also an educational aspect we can apply to this. Since Minecraft has books in it, we can partner up with local libraries and have their database of books be shared online for everyone to be able to read while playing Minecraft. And at the end of our campaign, we want people to remember the experiences they had and the optimism they've got from playing our game. So we're gonna take their creations back to the real world and create installations based on their creations. So as a short recap, we create awareness about a new united Europe that stays inside and takes a pledge of isolation by creating in the most therapeutical and fun way. People will become citizens in this world. It's inclusive and aims to attract everyone to stay inside and play. It will feature your favorite experiences and new ones. It will feature events. It has educational applications, and it will echo back into the real world when the crisis has died down. Now, my colleague Stephanie will continue and tell you about more about what we aim to do with this campaign.
Yes, so what do we actually want to achieve with that campaign? By creating a place that celebrates life and the places we miss, we'll bring together millions of people all around Europe to be united in their isolation and make the future exciting again, have or be a part of something big. And we create a lot of buzz. A therapy for millions of people, an uplifting way of keeping the mental health sane. A space that allow people to dream and start again. A creative space that brought back hope to 27 countries. So join and play and create your own world you want to love on europeanunion.org. Thank you.
Cool. Super cool. So, Josh, I mean, I'd like to be a citizenship of Europe. Maybe you make passports as well. My only question is, yeah, are we in the real world now or in this world they created? Are we in the real world or are we there already in the computer game world?
Exactly. Like, I think, we are already in the digital world, right? Yeah. In this case, you know, we are bringing people, we are inviting people to play.
I know the first guys who share your idea is the boys of Yamshit, because they are the gamers, the best gamers in Europe, in Berlin, wherever. Cool. Thank you. Thanks a lot. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Cool. So team number six, Marcelo, your crowd.
Hello. I'm here.
You're here. Yeah.
You too.
I'm happy that you're here. Thanks again for sharing, helping and sharing.
Hi, and just a few words about the guys and the idea. I'm very happy to work with them. I think Marco, João, Hans, and Tomás did a great job, and I'm very happy with the campaign because they found a very human insight and transformed this into a driven, business-driven campaign, and with a main goal that actually trying to make people in Europe come back again and start to see each other in Europe as a human being again, which is that I think is the greatest problem of at all. And Paulo will show the campaign, and I think it's great.
Okay, so Marco speaking here. Hello, everybody. Thank you. I will stop the video and share the screen. Maybe I can send you the link of the video if it won't work.
But Marco, if your computer, like if you mute your visual and share your screen, we see nothing, my friend.
Ah, okay, sorry.
Obviously.
Okay, are you seeing now?
Beautiful.
Thank you. So let's start. Okay, so we as a group, we decided to went straight to work on the travel argument, because as also other groups mentioned earlier, the COVID virus took away from us UAE citizen the privilege to travel and to be free to travel through EU countries. So COVID is bringing back borders to European Union. And not only geographical ones, but also the invisible ones that maybe are the worst for us UAE citizen, such an economic division. And this is happening, the tourism, that is our main power to beat these invisible borders, is passing some strange times and is far from being totally recovered. And we want to use this phrase from Cartesio, cogito ergo sum, that means I think, therefore I am, in the last years. But for today's days, we found another version from an anthropologist that said convivibo ergo sum, I cohabit, therefore I am. Because there have been many pandemics in the history of mankind, but never before such an event on a scale of all the mankind is being experienced, being aware that other people are in the same situation as us. And this is because of technology. And this brings us to feel that when we are more distanced from the others, we increase the awareness of the importance of social proximity. So now I will share with you this video. Hopefully you can see it. However, I sent you the link to feel the mood of our project that we'll see together. Okay. Okay. So, Leaving Europe is the name for our campaign, and with is double meaning, because we can pronounce it like Leaving Europe, so leaving, or live in Europe. So. And now you will understand why. Leaving Europe is a digital platform where you can connect with people from other countries and experience their culture and giving back to them the joy, the freedom, and the safety to travel in Europe. And which people better than the Airbnb host can bring cultural experience online? In fact, we are trying to participate together with Airbnb to create this online platform where our, as citizen of Europe can go and have an experience offered by an Airbnb experience host. And with this, making donation, economical donation, to the European Tourism Association to be ready to take another step forward through the new type of tourism that Europe should build now. Here you can see the screen of our platform that will be a website where you can travel between different countries, choose different cities, and see a list of the available Airbnb hosts in it, read their interests, their passion, and choose which one you want to talk to understand better their culture. And maybe he can give you also advice to where to go when the borders will be again opened and you can travel for real to that country. This is our main key visual for the campaign, Live Like a Local, and Live in Europe logo. And we displayed some local situation like here with a Green Italy, another kind of key visual. But we won't stop here, and we want also to create a campaign that people can share on social media and can share the proud of being in Europe and in our country,
like a local, and living Europe local.
Okay. Okay. Now I'm not hear me two times, and those are the way we imagine it to decline the campaign. Also, like an Instagram filter that could be used on a live streaming also, and on like a GIF for Instagram, where every country could have one. Like, for example, this live like an Italian, but everyone is European in the end. And now we want to invite you to make the same as we made. So go live like everyone country are, but most of all, I think you should live like Marcelo.
Just poster boys, so and it's great. And
Brazilian.
Super, great. I mean, it's so fantastic to see the power of creativity, what creativity can do, just to travel without traveling, but with your brain, and to go around in Europe and live like an. I miss the Austrian, but whatever. I mean, to live like whatever. Super fantastic. Thanks a lot. And now, Jamshid, I think you are now nervous as never before, because your team.
I'm always nervous.
Your team is now on stage performing what you did with them.
I was born nervous. I had a pleasure to work with Sarah from Spain, Karin from Slovakia, Jan from Czech Republic, and Victor from Ukraine. It was super pleasant. I had the super pleasure to have Frank joining us twice, helping us from M Studios. I'm grateful for that. And as usual, I'm a provocateur, so I hoped my team gonna be provoking, and see there, they were provocateurs themselves. So enjoy the show. Victor, I give you the stage.
Yes, hello everyone. So we will be presenting it with Jan.
Hello everyone.
Jan, you're gonna share your screen?
Yeah, I'm working on that. I'm gonna share the presentation, and Victor is gonna tell you more about our small project.
Yes, we did a rehearsal, and looks like we are doing great with Jan. He knows when to turn on the next slide. So this is Team 7, and I will be showing you what we did, our idea. So Jamshid already told you something about us, but let's do it once more. So here we have Jan, who is designer, Sarah and Karen, copywriters, me, myself, a copywriter too, and our great coach, Jamshid. So we approached solving this brief by firstly just talking. And we wanted to figure out what's going on in Europe. So the ugly truth is that everyone's saving their own asses. And why does it happen? It is because we are humans, and humans are egocentric by nature. So this is such a strong thing. It's been with us for the whole history of humanity. And so we thought, well, we will not be preaching. We will not be telling to be good boys and girls because we cannot change it. We cannot change the human nature. Okay, we'll go creative and find a way how to use it for good. So to find a solution, we dug even deeper inside of selfishness and found an interesting insight. So when bad things happen, people tend to do irrational things like saving what's not needed in the end, the unimportant stuff. And we started thinking about things that we love so much that are in our apartments. And we came up with this one that the main question here, where do all of that comes from? And now I want you all for just a second, think about things that you love. Where do they come from? And this was the point when we understood. We all are so connected. We all use everything that we love from other countries, that this is going to be the thing that will show the connection between everyone in Europe. And this is going to be the thing that we want to raise awareness for. And this is going to be the thing that will help us use our selfishness as people to save others. So we made up a video which will make you think of this problem from a different point of view and will touch your heart. And now, Jan, please turn it on.
Give me just a second. I'm working on that right now. There we go. Enjoy, everyone.
Most humans don't like to be called selfish, but we are born this way. We don't want to share our toys. We seek all attention for ourselves. We sacrifice others to save our own skin. We even do it subconsciously. Humans are an egocentric species. It is an instinct that helps us save our lives and makes us want the best from every country. It is time to wake the selfish in you. When it comes down to desires, there are no borders or nationalities. Be the greatest collective ego. Save everyone to have it all again.
So that's it. I think we have to tell nothing more.
Thank you very much, boys. Back to you, HP.
This is the end. Thank you very much. Okay, we are flashed. Thank you very much. Thank you. I donate my ego. I have a very small one, but I donate it, okay?
We collect every possible ego and we spread it around Europe.
We can take even my super small ego. The next team is mine, or is the team of and surprise, team number eight is not having just one idea with Andre, Michel, Vicky and Gonzalo. We will benefit you with two ideas, just in 5 minutes. So, team number eight, are you ready to rumble? Who will start? Michelle, Vicky, Andrei?
Oh, I'm first.
Andrei, okay. Here comes the Ukraine. Kiev has Easter today, and Andrei will show you in 5 minutes the first cool idea.
Yes, I try. Hi there. It's our idea with Gonzalo Ramos, so we start. Europe sounds. So at first we will, do you see anything?
Yeah, we see your face and your page.
Oh, it's strange.
It's good, you can go.
But there is now the second slide. So, okay, just imagine. Imagine there you see a big concert hall and you see a great orchestra that's sitting in this concert hall. Maybe 14 great musicians, and you're waiting that just now they will be loud, they will be great, and it will be fantastic music. But instead this, you hear just a bassoon, one instrument, and this instrument is weak, and it's the part of the one instrument that even not recognizable, and it's different from the melody, the great melody. So instead this, you see something weak. So our message is that Europe is this concert hall. The European country is musicians, and if together they play, they will be great. And if they will play divide, so they will be weak, not so strong. So, but nevertheless, many Europeans want to be individuals, and some European countries as well. So coronavirus increased this trend. So we had an idea. So we launched a challenge to create the world's largest European orchestra where musicians are all Europeans and musical instruments are cups, tables, pipes, voices, hammers from all over the Europe. So separately, it sounds weak and weird, but together it will be the greatest anthem of the United Europe. So, what we want? We want to create a site, online concert hall, where people can perform the symphony together. It will be the ninth symphony of Beethoven, so the hymn of the Europe. The page will have a notes and background music so that the participants does not stray and the sound engineers can easily make the sound design. So the video piece will be joined by other, which together will create Beethoven ninth symphony. And also the site will have a transparent map of Europe, so the city and village where the person posted the video will come colored. So we will further motivate people to participate and make the town visible and visit all Europe. So of course, there will be the challenge when person has completed their part, they post it on social network and tag a friend from non-participant city just to have more people who wanted to take a part and make Europe visible. So, and we think about the promo. So in the video that Gonzalo Ramos, I think, had to share a link, Gonzalo, please. And in the video, we will show a large orchestra. As I said, the conductor starts managing, but out of 40 musicians, only one bassoon plays. So this part sounds boring and does not resemble any tune. So Europe only sounds together. Play your part. So the promo could be the same, for example, for the radio, or can be like performance in the real concert or during a football match, when the big orchestra, from the big orchestra plays only one musicians, and it can drive, and it can be a good informational drive for the media. So the idea that Europe only sounds together, and play your part. So when you play alone, it sounds weak. When you play with everyone, when all European countries are together, they can create something amazing, and Europe's the same. So thank you. Дякую. And I give to another our team.
Hold on a second, because of course you have to hear the music. The single influence. Thank you very much. The second idea, please. The second idea. Fast. Second idea.
Okay, so guys, I'm going to run you through the second idea of team number 8. Now let's go. So for the second idea, we started from the insight that people miss and almost forget what it felt like to do a lot of things because of quarantine. The problem is when people fantasize about all the things they'd like to do during quarantine, they focus more on the when instead of focusing on the feeling they'll get when they'll be able to do all these things again. So what we want to do with our idea is focus on the feeling and excite people that they'll be able to relive all these things for the first time again after quarantine, presenting Europe's first times. So first times are really emotional and they connect all of us. And I think I speak for all of us, for all Europe, that we're all looking forward to this moment. Your first hug with your loved ones after quarantine. So as United People of Europe, we really want to give hope to the people out there and give them something to look forward to by telling them you'll be able to relive your first hug, which is a very special moment. You'll be able to relive your first kiss, your first adventure, your first night out, and so many more things, be it a coffee, be it a festival, a beer with your buddies. So we really want to give people something to hope and look forward to in social media posts and moving image. Relive all your first moments. So once we show people there's a light at the end of the tunnel, we'll create Europe's first bucket list, an Instagram filter that where people can share what they're most excited about doing after lockdown and share it with your friends and challenge your friends to do the same. So what happens after the lockdown? So once the lockdown is over, people are going to go out there and experience their first times, and we want to be there. So we'll launch a new first time initiative, which will see stories that include the new first time sticker added to a collective story that showcases everything people are going to do after the lockdown. So it's kind of a continuation of the stay home sticker, the thank you hour sticker. So we have the stay home at the beginning of the lockdown, the thank you hour during, and the first time sticker is for after the lockdown. So here's how it works. You put it in your story. My first kiss, for example, you post it and automatically you get inside the first time collective stories. So we'll collect all this user generated content and put it on Instagram, on the United People of Europe's Instagram, but we'll also have a platform which is called Europe's First Times that will collect collections of Europe's first reunions, Europe's first kisses, and so on. And with all this content, we're going to produce ads as well, which could look a little bit like this. So the wait is going to be worth it because all these moments are going to be very special. So again, We'll put all of this on europesfirsttime.eu, and there's going to be a collection of all the best moments of the first times. But because the first times are not only important after the lockdown, but in general, we want the platform to live on and inspire people to experience new first times across Europe by traveling across Europe and reunited in the future. So thank you for listening. I hope you'll all get your first hugs, your first kisses, your first reunions soon again. Thank you.
Oh. Thank you.
Hug you. Fantastic. I mean, whose team was that? Well, whatever. this was team number 8. I don't know which coach had been there, but it is a fantastic idea. Great. Thank you very much. Unfortunately, Amir has some technical problems. Team number 9 has been coached by Amir Kassaei, and I shall tell you that it is, of course, the best idea we all have. I haven't seen it yet, but I'm really, really curious to see what team number 9 generated. I mean, it's we all had sort of the same briefing, and so many different emotional, fantastic ideas so far. Super. I'm really blushed. And now, team number 9, Amir Kassaei's Rockers. Rockers. Who will do it?
Yep. Here I am. So we are sharing the screen. Just a second.
You look like a poodle.
I will think that it's a compliment. So.
Of course, a nice poodle.
All right. Everybody ready? All right. So we're team number 9. That's Ella, Agnese, Daniel, and Sebastian. Our coach was the man, the myth, the legend, Amir. Next slide, please. Right. We as Europeans should stay united because we're weaker apart. But right now, during the Corona lockdown, that's impossible. Next slide, please. But we still need to support people physically and mentally and embrace the idea of a united Europe.
Yep. And the context of this problem is that like all the industries have been affected by the COVID. And one of the most affected industry is obviously tourism. And the big guys, like big chains, will recover from this, but the local restaurants and small tourism agencies, which actually makes each of our countries so unique, will not. So how can we support the tourism industry and help people still experience the joys of traveling and help people to stay connected with each other during this lockdown? We think that self-isolation shouldn't stop us from traveling, and we will give people ability to travel while support the tourism industry and introducing the first ever digital travel agency, Sofa Tours. Yeah, and here's our homepage, Agnes.
Here I am. So as you can see, the site web is really simple and direct. So you can immediately choose the packages, because we are doing 3 packages, 1 2 days in this example. You can choose the city of Milan, but what you can do in Milan, you can have a guided virtual tour, for example, to the Castello Sforzesco, Duomo of Milano, Palazzo Reale, who are one of the most attractive areas. And then you can have a meeting with locals in the night in Navigli. And or you can even have a view an online show in the Teatro della Scala. And why not cooking masterclass with a local chef? But how does work all this? Thanks, Smirnov. Okay. How do it works? Each tour group will be made about with 10, 15 people from all over the world. And every day it will be a full experience from the morning to the evening. Local guides, chef will be the guide to this experience, guide you inside this new experience of traveling. But we didn't stop here because we recruit all the staff through the funds. European Travel Commission, for example, money raised from each tour will go direct to these funds to help local businesses who will be the most affected by this coronavirus crisis economy. And live tipping will be available throughout the tour and locals involved. Next.
Yep. And going to the implementation. Sorry, we just lost one slide. Ella, can you just talk about it?
Okay. okay. So we did have a slide. Basically, we're going to be making a Twitter page, and the Twitter page is going to have a picture of. It's basically a profile called Your Sofa. So we were thinking that everyone is complaining about their trips being cancelled and not being able to go away. But have you ever thought about your sofa? It's never left. It's never been able to go on a trip abroad. So we were going to make a Twitter account for it, basically saying, we're going to use social listening to find people complaining about their trips being cancelled, and the sofa account will reply to them, basically telling them, like, complaining. I mean, it's hard to say without showing it, but it will basically say back to them, you know, I can't believe you're complaining, like, I've never left the house. And then direct them to a link so that they can book a trip on their sofa.
So, yeah. So here we have...
Okay, here we go.
Yeah. So
that probably makes more sense when you can see it.
So that's an example of a tweet. Yeah.
And we'll carry this activation across to Instagram as well.
Cool. Okay, yeah. So just a second. Sorry for this technical stop. Yeah. So to summarize the idea, our first virtual travel agency, Sofa Tours, will help to keep local businesses alive and bring adventure and cultural education to all who are trapped, to all of us who are trapped in the lockdown now. Yeah, and the last but not least, another part of our campaign is in Instagram mask, and it's actually working. So you can use your phone and scan the QR code and try it right now. Yeah, thank you. And if you have Instagram, just scan the code and check out our mask.
Cool. Good. Cool. Thank you. Terrific. Thank you. Fantastic. I like your mask. Let's travel next time. Let's travel in real time, not at all. Frank, I will ask you later on. You are there. I will ask you what which of the campaigns you will do at the first in whatever. But we have another group waiting desperately to tell us their fantastic idea. Group number two, Michelle, Michael, Stiebel, your group is now ready. I hope so. Is it?
Yes.
I hope so too. Can you hear me okay?
Yes.
Well, yeah, I don't want to hear you, but yes, I hear you okay.
All right. Thank you very much. This has been a fabulous Creative Express because it's just been so outrageously different from everything we've done before. This technology kind of sucks, but it's great to keep us together. I had a magnificent team of four ladies, Chiara Gilmartin from Ireland, Lydia from Austria, Vitote from Lithuania, and Sarah from Spain. all four took the brief, chewed it up, discussed it at enormous length, and then rejected the most of it to come up with the concept that they have here, which you can see the basic, so we call it the basic idea behind it, which is to reunite. In order to reunite something, you have to have a disunity. The basic feeling is that we have a disunity in the European Union right now. It's been taken very seriously. And they've got an idea how to fix it. Okay, so it's going to be over to Chiara.
Yeah.
And she's going to present this to everybody. Enjoy.
Okay. Can you see my screen?
Yes, we do.
Okay, super. So, hello, we're team two. Thank you for that introduction. And we're just gonna go straight into the idea. So our way in was that when a global pandemic shook the entire world, European people should have been there for one another. We should have been looking out for each other's human rights. But we're all human. And humans make mistakes. But when we make really big mistakes, we're not promoting human rights, but rather human wrongs. Mistakes are a fact of life, but it's the response to error that counts. Let's acknowledge, learn, and grow from our mistakes and reunite so that we can come out of this pandemic a stronger and more united Europe than we were before. So our idea is to create the Pandemic Declaration of Human Wrongs. So we will release our official Declaration of Human Wrongs all across Europe when the last country is reopening their borders. The virus might be gone, but it will have left a path of destruction throughout our society. It's time to acknowledge our human wrongs. We will release the list of human wrongs all across Europe, online as well as offline, in order to reach a broad audience. We want to start a Europe-wide intergenerational movement. Now we have a TVC, the Vimeo link is in the chat. So if everybody could just take 2 minutes and watch that video, that would be great.
Everyone, please make sure while you're watching it, you mute yourself so that it's no tremendous echo here. That would be awesome. Chiara, you can start mentally counting 2 minutes, you know?
Yeah. Okay, so is everybody finished?
I am.
Okay, super.
Yes, please unmute yourself again and say yes.
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 Good.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
So go ahead, please.
So after our declaration and TVC has launched, we want to encourage people across Europe to join the movement. So our website will encourage people to add their own wrongs to the declaration. We will also use paid social to reach people, asking them to add their voices to the campaign. People's wrongs will get posted on our social accounts as well as out of home, all across Europe. Your grandma died because of me. Remember the earthquake last month? Me neither. Thanking the essential workers of the pandemic with minimum wage. We see fragments of the EU flag star throughout our campaign to convey that they are currently broken. So posting our wrongs on and offline all over Europe will give people a chance to acknowledge, blame, and get some closure over the many wrongdoings of the pandemic. And we know that after wrong comes right. So when the mood across Europe begins to shift, we can adapt our channels to begin to show this optimistic shift. We'll begin to display positive and hopeful messages in the place of wrongs. In terms of longevity, our overarching platform, Reunite, is an initiative by the EU that aims to rebuild the European community after the aftermath of crisis. Our campaign, the Declaration of Human Rights, was the first campaign for this initiative, which we see living well beyond the aftermath of the coronavirus pandemic. Thank you.
Well done, Chiara.
Oh, so fantastic. So fantastic. Great. Now we had all the 9 teams. Girls, boys, team, help us. I'm really now overwhelmed with creativity and with your power you gave to yourself, to us, to the group. It's really, really something. And I'm, I don't know, maybe it's a creative express with the most outcome so far, although we didn't meet in reality, but it's really amazing what happened in these 3 days. I do have my favorites, of course, and you might know which group that they have been, but they are all of your ideas are really fantastic. Frank, maybe I'll ask you. You have been the first time with the Creative Express. What do you think? A first statement from a team who supported us as well. The M Studios supported us. Some teams have been talking to them. Frank, are you here?
Yes, I am. I'm listening. Yes.
There are more people. Shut up.
So yes, thanks for having me. And my first thoughts are like that's been like some very tough days for the teams, but it's a great job, great insights, great work for such a short time and under that kind of pressure. It's really been nice to see such amount of work. And my first thoughts were like, besides some great insights, we as like MediaCom M Studio Group M, we look at our clients and we have hundreds of clients. And during this crisis, they asked us, oh, what kind of campaigns could we do? And I saw a lot of great insights, great things. So it's like a really great thing. For example, the Airbnb kind of approach, you know, there were one of my clients also back at TBWA. So I think there's some fields where we can dig into, like supermarkets, make cooperations with supermarkets.
Hungry for Europe. Hungry for Europe is like it's open for, I mean, Unilever is loving you.
Exactly. It's like, or for example, Lidl, one of our clients, or TUI, and L2s, clients of us, I can see some approaches where we can go further with those ideas. So that was my first thoughts on that.
Cool, cool. Thank you very much. We will deliver you with all of you with all the campaigns. This was 3 days of hardworking stuff and of being creative. And I know that some teams didn't sleep last night. It's really amazing. And to show you the emotion which can appear through digital channels is, please, all of you, mute again. Switch on your microphone, please. All of you, switch on your mic.
On.
Because yeah. Are you there? Steffi has birthday today, and like I would like to sing for Steffi, and but it's not the usual song. It's
you are
21. Congratulations.
Had you been celebrating in so many different countries at the same time before?
Never. It's so cool, really. Thank you.
Tanya, you can invite your boyfriend to come in the room and say happy birthday from all of us. The poor guy is still suffering also. He has a birthday today.
Yeah. And also my Kosa born today.
Yeah. Wow.
Congrats. Yeah.
Great,
Tony. If
this can be
endless.
Thank you, everybody, for taking part in this.
Yeah, one of you guys need to switch off.
I don't have to switch on. Thank you, everybody, to take part, to be part of this really, really amazing first digital viral creative express. Thanks, Yanni, again. Thanks, Yamshit. It was really fantastic what you did with all this structure and stuff like that. Merci, where are you? Thank you. Kisses to the Queen of Barcelona. Queen of Catalonia.
Hello.
you all will be invited for this or that event here or there in Barcelona. We are, of course, producing for you, not with Riga, but with Viral. You will get one.
Yeah.
Thanks for the 150 participants in the morning with yoga lesson. It was fantastic. And I'm just super proud and happy now. And we'll have another cigar and whatever.
I want to say something, and Jam wants to say something before me. Yes, go ahead.
I want to say probably what you want to say. I just wanted to ask all of you, the ADCE will be in touch with you, share a link to a folder where you can please upload all your presentations and everything else so that we can process it and share it with everyone and get it out to the world and all of that. So that would be awesome if you respond to their request. They will ask you, they have all your email addresses, so that would be done for sure.
Yeah.
You all will get also a sort of a document that you participated on this special event. This document will be digital, so it will delete immediately. No, you get a paper.
I want one of those. What is it, your own emoji or what? Happy emoji?
This one?
No, it was another one showing up earlier.
Hannes was putting one in the screen.
Okay, Hannes, was it you?
Okay.
Hannes.
It's part of Apple's way to get you stuck in their machines.
Well, first, I want to thank everyone, of course, participating, all participants, all coaches, Jamshit. It's been great to have you for the first time here in our Creative Express. I hope it will be the last one. And HP, of course, super thanks for all your, we started just talking through emails and then we are here, we've done it, we make it. congratulations to everyone. Maybe Hannes, on behalf of the ADC board, because you are one of the members, actually, you want to say something? I just...
Always as a surprise. yeah, what can I say more than you have said everything? Thanks to everyone. Thank you, HP, for asking me to join. It's always a pleasure. I have to say, I really lack a lot of the personal emotion and personal connection that we had in Rome. That was a fantastic Creative Express 3 years ago. I loved the first one in the train, and as nice as it was, it's not the same. And I really, really hope that this fucking disease, whatever, is just leaving us again, and we will all be able to meet. If not this end of this year, we will meet again next year and hug each other. And I'm just,
exactly.
Yeah, it's just, I'm getting a bit sad. So I stopped talking, but it was great. And it was great to work with all of you together. Thanks.
Just share the hugging film, from Michelle and Vicky. Share the hugging film, download it on your mobile and send it around, the hugging film from Michelle, and it's so emotional. But all of the ideas, fantastic. I mean, I'm just really overwhelmed with your creative power. Thank you.
Another thing, and we take all the ideas with us, of course, ADCE, and together with Ben and Frank and any brand that wants to join us.
Hello.
Do you want to say something, Marcelo?
Yeah, guys, next time I'll meet you all again, we have to get so drunk.
Great. Oh yeah, for sure. I mean it.
Like,
guys, a beijo for you guys.
What we did in Riga, right? With our tequila.
Oh my God, that was
okay.
Crazy.
Let's do that this. Let's do this.
Dancing under the tunnel.
Yeah. Okay, so just to finish, I think everyone is tired. So I promise from ADC, we will be all invited to come to Barcelona whenever we can. I hope it will be next year, 2021. We will organize an event for you, for young creatives to come and to all meet in person and all to hug, to give a big hug, everyone, each other. Okay.
It was great.
This is to everybody. Hey,
thank you very much.
Thank you.
Bye, Team 8. You'll be the best
one.
Best team. Thank you.
Thank you. See you next time.
You know where he wants to go.
We can now put music, you know, and we can do a party, right?
The after party.
I want to say something.
Yeah. Yes.
There's a lot of women, which is something really inspiring. So I want to.
That's true.
Women power.
I love women. Yay, I also love women very much. Women are. I love women. I love.
Behave yourself.
Yeah, guys, it was amazing. Thank you.
Thank you,
Rita.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. Great. Anyone, if you want to say something, just unmute yourselves and go ahead.
Yeah.
I just made you talk.
I need a cigar.
Juliana, go.
Where is Stephanie? Oh, she's gone. Of course, it's her birthday. Damn. Oh, I just want to say, please get drunk. It was like, you know, awake for a long time, and I didn't know it was her birthday today. I learned today. So I was like, wow, very impressed, because, you know, she chose to be here with us. So, yeah, I mean, just want to clap for her.
Super.
Beautiful.
And to everyone, great work. Thank you for the invitation. And yes, I was very impressed with the number of women that we have. Usually it is not like that, unfortunately, but we are changing that. And Very proud to be here.
Woo!
We had fun too.
And it's been great to meet all your children there. I love that. Together,
yeah.
Working together in the yoga sessions, we had children, and then working, we had children. So we have to integrate everything, you know. It's no way otherwise.
That's my children.
Young creatives.
We need new talents. We need talents. So, what did Armin say at the beginning? Fuck. Well, whatever.
We cannot hear you, HP.
We can hear you double because you both.
Because
why don't you just sit together and chat through one microphone?
Exactly. Okay.
To have more children, like Mikey said. Amir said. Fuck.
You know what to do.
Shut up now. Get up. I'm off. I'm having a cigar now and I love you all.
By the way, did you see that a couple of pandas in China had sex for the first time?
One time a year. Whatever. Bye-bye.
Okay,
Bye.
I'm going to stop the live on YouTube, right? Just in case you want to continue doing whatever, right?
I also stop the recording here.
Yes.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye. YouTube.
Juliana, I'm a very big fan. Hey, I hope to meet you one day.
Fantastic support from you and Frank. Thank you.